Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny Tim talking Sculptra and Sculptra Dilutions. I get asked this all the time. I get text messages and emails about what dilution for what area. It's very difficult to teach something like this over the phone or over the internet, but I want to give you some concepts. A lot of what I do on Sculptra is working off the bone, the temple and the bone and the high cheek particularly. And the concentrations here are gonna be much more concentrated than the lower face. And that's why I add PlasmaSculpt often to the lower face. But when you're using Sculptra with PlasmaSculpt or alone, it's gonna be much more dilute because we're in the soft tissue region and you don't need the concentrations that you might need on the bone. Now, if someone has had one or two treatments and they're not getting the volume they want, then increasing the concentrations gradually is a safer way to do it. Also, around concentric muscles like the mouth or the eye, and of course we never inject the under eye with Sculptra, those are areas that we would even be more dilute, meaning maybe the oral commissure, if you're treating there, you can be a little more aggressive in the nasolabial folds. And if you're treating the pregial sulcus, oftentimes you're on a periosteal level, but you still don't want to be as concentrated as you would in the upper face. So concentrations of Sculptra are very important to do in real life on real patients, but it's what makes Sculptra the most incredible art to treat patients with, and it what makes it so dynamic and increases patient satisfaction, because remember, you can thicken the dermis, you can give them better skin and a youthful glow that you can't with other products, and it works in combination with hyaluronic acid fillers. So for some people, once I talk to them, it becomes clear to them that a hyaluronic acid filler might be a better choice for their practice for the lower face, and then adding Sculptra as a last skin tightener in a skin tightening dose as opposed to a volume dose would be more appropriate. So not to make it complex, but people who do a lot of Sculptra are varying the concentrations all the time. How do I get to 18:1 dilution? People will ask. What you do is you take out your 9:1, and say you take out 1.5 cc's in your 3 cc syringe. Then you pull water, or in this case, once it's diluted, you can use normal saline with preservatives. And then you can add another 1.5 cc, and that takes you from a 9:1 to an 18:1 concentration, because you can't get 18 cc's in the bottle. There's a little quick tip for you. So Sculptra and dilutions, it's somewhat complex, it's a bit of an art, it's a bit of looking at the skin of your patient, the dermal thickness, what their goals are, and what else you're gonna combine with the Sculptra to get that beautiful look that they're desiring. So thanks for joining me today. Love to hear your Sculptra tips below. Click like if you've liked the video, subscribe, join us on Instagram for before and afters and more tips to help keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.